I am so excited about this project. Let me show you how I added Wi-Fi to my 3D printer. I always wanted to have a quick way to keep an eye on my 3D printers, see the progress, and have some basic controls. From what I found, the only way to do that remotely is to use something like a Raspberry Pi running Octoprint. While it's an amazing and powerful project, I was looking for something that's simple, affordable, and instantly on. That is why I came up with this. It runs on an ESP8266 module, connects directly to the printer, and boots up instantly. You are looking at the printer's dashboard. It has multiple tabs that show different things. The main tab here shows the overall status of the printer. I can see the nozzle temperature, the bed temperature, the print time, the print progress, along with the name of the file that's being printed. It has action buttons to print, pause, or stop a print job, along with the current Z height, feed, and flow rates. Also at the bottom, I added some graphics to plot the temperatures as they come in, and also the location of the nozzle. The second tab shows the list of the files on the SD card. On the right hand side, it displays the file size and the ability to print it. The third tab here is the terminal. It can be used to send G-code commands to the printer directly or to monitor the raw data coming in from it. The rest of the tabs are there for configuration and setup. I will skip those for now, however, I can visit them in a different video if needed. So this is the dashboard. I tried to make it simple, free of clutter, and straight to the point. And it is very practical too, so I can view it on my laptop, iPad, or even my phone. Now let's talk about how it works. But if you don't care for that and just want to see the installation part, jump to this timestamp. Now let's talk about how it works. The concept behind it is relatively simple. There is an ESP8266 microcontroller that sits between the dashboard and the serial port on the 3D printer. By using a socket, I'm able to connect those two. In one direction, it takes the commands coming from the dashboard and sends them to the printer console over serial. In the other direction, it monitors the printer console and sends all the incoming messages to the dashboard. By the way, all the following logic that you'll see was done using JavaScript. Okay, so when the dashboard receives a message from the printer console, it parses it and extracts data from it. It uses this data to update the interface in real time. For example, when it receives this line, using regular expression, it knows that this is the temperature reading. It extracts the bed temperature from it, then it uses this new bed temperature value to update this web interface block immediately using JavaScript. This process repeats over and over for each message it receives. It is currently programmed to parse dozens of data points, and more can easily be added in the future. One challenge I faced was that not all the data I need to have a useful dashboard was provided by the printer at runtime. For example, the printer doesn't automatically send updates about the print time or the percentage while it is printing. So in this scenario, I added a small script that periodically requests the print time or percentage using the M31 and the M27 G-code commands. That means every 30 seconds, the printer receives the M31 and the M27 G-code commands and responds with the print time and percentage. These messages are treated like all incoming messages. They get parsed, extracted, and the dashboard is updated. I have also used this technique for other on-demand requests. For example, when I click on the Files tab, it sends the M20 G-code command, asking for the list of the files on the SD card. Then the printer replies with the file lists, and that gets parsed and displayed. And this is how the communication between the dashboard and the printer is handled. At the beginning, I had the serial monitoring, the socket, and the dashboard all running on the ESP8266 port. But later, I decided to host the dashboard externally. This made updating the dashboard much easier, and I don't have to reflash the ESP8266 each time I have a small HTML or a JavaScript changed. At the same time, I discovered GitLab Pages, which I used to host the dashboard's HTML, CSS, and JavaScript files for free with the full power of CI/CD. I felt it was a good fit. So how does the installation look like? Well, I did it in three different ways, and they all give the same results. For the first, I used an ESP01 module. For the second, I used a WeMustD1 Mini. And for the third, I built a custom board to address all the challenges I faced with the first two. For all three, there are four connections: TX, RX, ground, and power. I had to do a bit of research to figure out where things were on my printer. Also, the power pin varies depending on which installation I used. For example, the ESP01 needs the 3.3 volts, while the WeMustD1 Mini needs either 3.3 or 5 volts. Ground was easy. It goes to any ground pin on the printer. Finding RX and TX can either be easy or tricky depending on the printer. Some printers have them exposed and some are really hidden. For the hidden ones, I found a good trick, which is tapping into the USB to serial port. Most budget printers have this chip. With a quick search, I found the schematic. The TX and RX are at the top here, and this is what I use for my Ender 3 V2. This, however, required fine soldering, so I understand it might not be for everyone, but I was comfortable enough going in there and soldering by hand. And that's how I installed it. It was done and it was ready to use. However, there were small challenges. One was the Wi-Fi signal issues. My 3D printer has a metal frame. The enclosure for its motherboard was also all metal. Initially, I left the ESP8266 boards inside and I faced a lot of timeout and speed issues. And when I realized that, I used long wires and moved my devices outside of the enclosure, and everything worked perfectly fine after that. And two, finding power source for my device wasn't easy. Especially after adding the auto bed leveling, I had no ports left on my printer. That's why I built this companion board. And now today's video sponsor, PCBWay. I have been using PCBWay for years, and they are my go-to manufacturer for all my prototypes. I've been averaging a week from the time I place an order to the time I have them in my hands. I'm very happy with the quality so far, and ordering PCBs have come a long way, especially for hobbyists. So I encourage you to give them a visit. I will put a link to their site down below. Now back to my board. I used an ESP07 module, which is based on the ESP8266 microcontroller, but it has an external antenna. So everything can be left inside the metal enclosure, but the antenna could be installed outside. This companion board also takes care of the power. I noticed the LCD cable has 5 volts and ground rails, so I made the board sits between the motherboard and LCD cable to take advantage of that. Now I don't have to worry about the power, and all I have to do is solder 2 pins. And that's pretty much it. So once I have it installed, to start using it, I visit the dashboard's URL and provide the IP address of the board, which I call the 3D printer wireless gateway. And voila, my printer is online and I can access it wirelessly. But before I wrap things up, I will leave you with the bin files for the ESP01 or the WeMustD1 Mini if you want to try this project at home. Let me know if I should create a how-to installation video or if the instructions were clear enough in this video. And if you want the companion board, I will make that available on my store as well. I started this project over a year ago. I'm super happy with where it is now. I can pull up my phone anytime to check the progress without having to run down to the printer. I hope you enjoyed it or even learned a thing or two. Oh, and I just received the Prusa Mini, and I noticed it has a built-in ESP01 port, and I know it also runs G-code, so in theory, I can load an ESP01 with my code, plug it in, and it should work. I'm so excited to try that one. You gotta have to come back to see how that unfolds. So that's it for me. Thank you for watching, and happy printing!